Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. As you can see, I changed up the squad a bit from what I promised earlier. I've added one of our squaddies, actually Cecil Harambé. Bavarius is his nickname, and he's our second grenadier instead of Geralt, because we can actually try and take one of the squaddies with us. It's not going to be that much of a difference, especially on the grenadier slot, that's the squad: Ulrich, Terillia, Cecil, Christoph, and Benito Buffon. Here we go. So, retaliation, which means that we're gonna have to try and save as many civilians as we can. And hopefully that will go pretty smoothly. So, Operation Black Tears, here we go.
Just got word the aliens are hitting a resistance outpost with everything they've got, and our people don't stand a chance against them. We're heading in to secure the area. Eliminate all enemy contacts.
And that we will. So neutralize all enemy forces and rescue at least 6 civilians. The other thing we have that might come in handy is Benito's scanning ability that might reveal some hidden faceless before they actually start to do some damage. I don't know what's happening with the frame rate. That is not your viewer. There we go. That solved it. So that was probably the loading time. And welcome Cecil to the team. Hopefully you will do amazing on your first mission. And there we go. Independence point on New Arctic. It seems like, wasn't that the same one as the previous retaliation mission? Well, never mind. Dropping us off. We're not going to be in concealment, but of course Christoph will be, so that's going to be really handy, because I don't think we had that in the previous retaliation mission either.
Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
So we're going to use Christoph heavily in this mission. There we go.
You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Yes, we will. Yes, we will, Bradford. Yes, we will indeed. But let's keep the cover anyway. What's that?
Has done everything it can to convince people to join the cause, but it's an uphill battle when you've got Advent whispering propaganda in your ear 24 hours a day.
Are we looking at the broken down door for that or what? So that's going to break concealment. If I can put... I wonder, does that actually break concealment if you save a civilian? Let's try it.
That's affirmative.
Here we go.
Let's go, move out.
There we go, that's one civilian rescued already. That's gonna be easy with Christoph in our squad. Let's put Cedric up immediately, so that we have a sort of overwatch position to everything around us. Let's put him here, so somebody else could get up to the roof if it's needed. Doesn't seem like he's triggering anything. Vrijer, start moving up heavily, because I think we can safely assume that there's nobody around. Well, not next to the starting area either way. So Cecil, let's put you here. And you know what? Just move up towards those barrels over here. And then let's put Benito on overwatch just in case. Who's going to die? There seems to be aliens far away over there. Ooh. And not just one alien. Seamus Daly was killed, and that was a muton, so we're gonna have mutons on this mission. Damn. That might be tough. Okay, since we don't trigger anything by saving civilians, let's move forward. We can swap even, so he doesn't see anything. For some reason, he doesn't have sight inside of the shed over there, so... I could try and boost up towards this third civilian, but I want to check out... Is there anybody else around here? Seems like that's the edge of the map. Seems like that's a small... Not that wide... Ooh, no. It goes on pretty far for some reason. Let's put you in here either way. Because that might actually help us out if we have 3 civilians saved already. You know what? I don't want to risk it. I really don't want to risk it. So, because if he gets spotted, that's going to be the end of the mission right there. So let's put you over here behind cover. See if you can't spot anything from over there. He doesn't. Does that mean that it's free over here as well? Probably not. Let's just slowly move everybody up.
Coming up.
There we go. Let's put you over there. Don't seem to spot anything yet. We can move to the sides pretty far. There we go. Let's put Bavarius right next to Christoph, actually. That's a nice position to start off from. Do I move Cedric up a bit? I could, but I think he's pretty good on this position. So let's just put him on Overwatch. Put Vrijer here as well. Because we can use the heavies if we need them. There we go. And oh, okay. That's good, because now we have a few... Ooh, there's a Muton in that team as well. But that's the end of the trooper. Thank you, Cedric. So that might help us put our focus on the Muton. And Cedric got a promotion as well from that. Hello! So that's one of the new enemy types, the Muton. There we go. Benito's Overwatch shot misses, sadly. And nobody else got a shot off, because I think... Yeah, nobody else was on Overwatch. Does he get... Ooh, there's a sectoid of... Oh! The sectoid just murdered the civilian we could still reach, so... That's annoying. Yep, you're mad, we get that. So, Mutons, pretty beefy. They get a lot of health. I think that's... On this difficulty, seems like that's 9 health. And 2 armor to start it off with, so... I don't think, yeah, Christoph is still out of concealment, in concealment. So we should focus on getting the heavies some points. 21%, that's not good at all, is it? And that tree is probably gonna hold against 2 grenades, but what other choice do we have, actually? He's not on Overwatch, so that's something we know. What's your shot? 33%, that's actually not that good either. I wonder if that's the same Muton from down over there. It's probably not, since he got up there so fast. Let's put Christoph a bit further and see what happens if we put him over here. If we trigger the sectoid... Yeah, okay. A Lancer... Ooh, 2 Lancers and a sectoid. So those guys could be killing off civilians pretty easily. We still need to rescue 4, so we can lose 5. But let's start raining it down here. I can't see the Muton from over there, apparently. Probably just too far away. But Cecil, let's put your frag grenade to good use and blast away the trees. Well, trees multiple here. We want to blast away the trees here. That should eliminate one of the armor points the Muton has as well. So let's try that. His first action, glorious explosions. 1 damage, 1 armor, and 1 shredded. There we go. And the tree is still standing, as expected. So, let's actually try and move closer with Benito. Because he can deal out the most damage right now. But he still can't see him. So I'm going to opt for his grenade. Toss that up there as well, and that should eliminate the tree permanently and remove his armor as well. There we go. Armor removed, tree removed, and 2 damage done. Let's see. Can we now kill him immediately with Cedric's spot? Why is his spot on fire? That's not good. Let's put you over here. Should give you... closer line of sight. There we go. A flank shot with the pistol. Lightning hands. Take it. There we go. 3 damage. And now we can do that again, I hope. And that should be able to kill him if it hits. So 3-4 damage. Please do. Oh, even a critical in the face. A Muton down.
Did you see that one?
Yeah, I did see that one. Now... What we should do is be extremely careful, of course, as always. So let's put... I think if I put Friar closer, he's the same distance to those guys as Christoph is. So he's gonna see them immediately. So I don't think I have much choice but to just wait this out. Because if I move closer... Am I gonna see him if I put him over there? I'm not gonna risk it. I can't simply risk it. So there we go. Christoph over there. What are those guys doing? They are retreating. Which gives us the opportunity to save a few more civilians. Although, of course, they're gonna kill him. So, Thomas Walker was down. Sorry. Really, really sorry I couldn't save you. Oh, wow. Hi. Okay, yeah, right. Okay, so Christoph is the only one that sees those guys. So I do have to be careful with Christoph rescuing these civilians, because if one of those is a faceless, I'm gonna be fucked. Because if it's a faceless, then I lose my concealment, and I think in this condition I'm gonna be triggered. I'm gonna trigger both of those groups, so don't really wanna do that. So Christoph, try and stay put a bit. Can you save this one over here? No, you can't. So I'm gonna try and put you a bit closer to... Can I see any other... Ooh, there's a civilian over here as well. So if I put you over here...
Heading to that location.
Does that do anything? No? Okay. Just gives us a better view. If I put Benito over here, I'm probably gonna trigger those guys. And I'm gonna have to start doing that, because otherwise... Yeah, otherwise things are gonna end badly. So... Can I start it off with a shot? That might actually be best, because now those stun lances are out of cover. That actually might be in my advantage. So take the back stun lancer and shoot him. Ah, 6 damage. Okay, so that's not a kill, but it's something to start off with. So 3 enemies, that's all there is to it. One of those is a mech though, so do need to be careful. So they take cover right next to Christoph for some reason. Let's see. I can't hack the mech from here, but I should be able to if I move closer. Probably next to one of the trees around here. Don't know if I'm actually going to be successful with that, so I'm going to have to be careful that I actually kill... Well, I'm able to kill the mech if I fail. I'm wondering... Luke Bavarius, put yourself in this... Wonder if I even have a flank shot if I put you over here, because he's not going to be able to move to the right to check that that stun lancer out. And I do have to be careful not to trigger that last batch over there as well. Yeah, go for this position. He doesn't trigger anything, I don't think. Yeah, they're not even... inside yet, so I wouldn't have triggered it otherwise as well. You could kill the Lancer over there, but we have a few other options. Ulrich, put yourself in this position then. Hopefully not triggering anything. No, he doesn't. So let's see. Yeah, he can't even see that one. So let's try and put a grenade. Yeah, we can get a grenade in between those two guys, damaging them both. So that will kill the one on the left. And we can move further from that. There we go. And blow them up. There we go. And now we have a clear shot on that Lancer. So Luke... Well, Luke, I'm calling you Luke because, well, I know the nickname of Bavarius is Luke Bavarius, but it's Cecil Harambe. 76% shot. If you hit this guy, you kill him. And that sounds like a hit. 6 damage. Thank you. His first kill. Awesome. Okay. Well, I'm saying awesome, but we still have a fucking mech to deal with. So, the one thing I could do. We know we can put you over here, Benito, without triggering anything, and then I'm gonna... Oh, shit. You still don't have line of sight. Is that tree just blocking him completely? Oh, that is bad. Yeah, I have no other choice than to just go on Overwatch. And I put you on Overwatch as well. Don't want to lose that concealment. Oh, there we go. Ooh, good riddance. I didn't try to save that one, so that's bad. Is he gonna immediately attack something? Oh shit. That's actually bad. Because I was hoping that Benito was going to fire at the faceless there. What is he doing? Oh, he's... Yep, Kazumi Nishimura was killed. Oh god, this is starting to look bad. Because I've only rescued two civilians yet, and that faceless is going to swipe somebody in the face. Oh, do you actually get an attack? Oh yeah, he does. That's 4 damage on Ulrich. Okay. Okay. Whew, nobody got killed. And actually... Gustav still has... Ooh, and there's 2 civilians over here. 3, actually. Ooh, now I'm really doubting what I should do. Because I think if I scan... So how far does that reach? Can't even see how far that reaches. Increasing the sight of your sight radius substantially for one turn, revealing any hidden or disguised enemies in view. Okay. Does that actually take 2 turns or 1? There we go. Okay, so that's a faceless as well. Well, better that we know it now than later. Because that would have been bad otherwise. Does he actually get a movement turn? What just happened? Is this one as well? No, okay, so they just made visible for me. Which means... Wait, do I get another turn now? Yeah, okay, so I can't shoot the faceless in the face. So, yeah, do that. Straight in the tummy, 6 damage. Okay. I don't have lightning reflexes, otherwise that would have been really nice. I think I'm gonna have to move. So if I put you over here on this square, that shouldn't trigger the faceless just yet, because I see his markings over there. So if you can save that civilian, that would be really nice. We know it's not a faceless. Okay, yeah, that's 3. And on the next turn, we can actually try... I do want to move him back. Because that faces is going to wreck... Oh no, that faces is going to kill the civilian, probably. So we still need to save 3, so we need to be careful, though. Going to put Christoph back. And now, we still need to kill a faceless over here. So Vryer, take a back seat for a minute. Full cover over here. I'm gonna... Ooh, take it easy. Take it easy, buddy. Take it easy. So that's full cover and that's full cover. So... Just want to put them in cover just in case the other guys start showing up. Although I think they're still going to be happily murdering civilians. So, Cecil, you need the promotion. So, let's try you first. 84%. Ooh, straight in the torso. And Benito doesn't know what to do. He's just looking at a higher target, but the target is down.
Running dry.
Okay, so Cecil is running dry. Cedric isn't in that good of a position, so I might actually move him up. Although I'm really, really scared as to what that entails. So, let's reload you. Yeah, reload. And then put you in full cover over here. Vryer. Yeah, Overwatch it is.
Give a fire shots.
So are they gonna come over here or are they going to kill more civilians? That is the question. Because we still have 4 enemies over there as well. Yeah, okay, they're still happily killing civilians. Rob Sullivan was killed. Does the mech get another separate turn? What is this face is going to do? Okay, so we get a shot off with Vryer, and it seems like the faces is moving past. That was not a miss, that was in the face. Okay, so he's moving past the civilian. What the fuck? How far can you run? Oh, okay, so that was his two turns. Jesus Christ, that was a mini heart attack. So now, he didn't kill that civilian over there, which is really, really good. I don't think he actually broke concealment either, so that's even better, actually. Don't have sight on the faceless for some reason. I'm gonna put you... Ooh, I can barely put you up here, but that's... That might trigger something else. I'm gonna have to try it anyway. Do you spot anything? You don't. Okay. Well, you do. You can see the faces over there, so... You know what? Why not? There we go. 3 damage. That's a good start if I want to save the rest of my soldiers for anything else. So, Ulrich. Fire away, I would say. That was a miss. That was for some reason... Oh, shit. This is gonna hurt.
Fehlschuss.
Okay, that's too bad. That means I'm gonna have to do this with my two other guys. You know what, we need to try first. You know what, since I'm not gonna move you, reload first. And then fire at the faceless. 7 damage, okay, he's down. He's down. That's good. Because now I can keep Christophe over here and actually let him save that civilian, which we also know is not a faceless. So put yourself over here and then we have 4 out of 6 civilians saved. And maybe he can spot someone else from over here. Doesn't seem like he... There's one over there, but that one might actually die. Oh, no, wait. Where's Christophe? What am I looking at? Where is everybody? Okay, so that's Christophe, and there's a civilian on the other side of the car there. I don't think we had 2 faces already, so I think we can actually save this, well, enough civilians to win the match. So let's reload Cecil and put you on Overwatch just in case the mech decides to turn back. Okay. There they are. So now we have actually a lot bigger of a problem. So he's gonna miss. Yeah, he's missing. Because the mech has a turn, I think.
Shot failed to connect.
Can he shoot at somebody? Okay, they don't. Whew. So that actually saves me a civilian as well. Cedric is in a bit of a pickle here. Although... Maybe he's not. If I put you over here on full cover. Oh, please don't trigger anything else. That would have been really bad. I have a lightning hand shot on the Lancer and he's flanked as well. There we go. 3 damage. And now Cedric actually has a grenade as well. If I put that right between those guys. Which I should be... Ooh. Damn it. Goddamn, I'm gonna have to wait with that. Because he still has a pistol shot as well, which is 100%, which might kill him as well. But it's not guaranteed either. So, let's check out everybody else. I think it's high time we use Christophe. If I put you over here, I can actually have a shotgun blast... Directed at the sectoid, maybe even killing him immediately. Then we have Benito, our technician. He doesn't have line of sight to the mech just yet, which... Oh, there's a civilian here as well. That is interesting. We might actually get someone to that position soon. So let's put Benito closer. We're gonna have to do that anyway. So now we can see the mech. What can we do with the mech? Because I think we can almost guaranteed disable it for a few turns. If not take control of it. So let's check the Haywire protocol. It's a bit sad because of his damage output, but... We might check that out as well, what his aim is at the mech. So 60% on a stun, I'm not even going to do that. That's a way too small chance to be able to kill him. Because he has, wait, 5 health and 2 armor left. Which means I'm either gonna have to... Ooh, these guys don't move too fast, do they? Four enemies. I think I can kill all of them, but that's gonna have to take a bit of luck as well. Because now we flank the sectoid and the stun lancer over there. The sectoid has 8 health, which we might actually get from here, but that's so risky. That is so risky. What are your shots, Benito? So you might kill the mech. And all the other shots are pretty bad, so you might actually have to take a shot at the mech. Let's try that first. Ooh, that's 1 damage short. That's 1 damage short. But that means we can probably kill him with Cedric over here, because he has a pistol shot of 100%. Okay, so the mech is dead. So the most dangerous enemy for now should be dead. What else do we have? We have grenades left, actually. We have a single grenade left with Ulrich, so if we put you over here, it's dangerous. But we might use your grenade right on... How much can we do? Yeah, like that. We can take care of the mech alongside with a bit of the lancer over there. And it should also remove his cover. So, is that the best option we have if I move one over to the right? Do we actually get 3 enemies here? Oh, there we go. That is lovely. Yeah, 3 enemies with 1 grenade. There we go. Go, Ulrich. That is a nice grenade. That bounced off from something. Okay, so they still have their cover. And now I actually, yeah, Ulrich got a promotion. Hopefully he lives to tell the tale. Then we have a pistol shot on a few guys. Might actually go for... They both have 4 health left, but only one has 100% shot chance. So yeah, let's try that. Hopefully 4 damage, please. Oh, even a critical in the face. Cedric is on fire on this episode. Okay, 2 guys left and 2 troops left. Should be guaranteed, right? I'm gonna use the flashbang, I think. So I'm gonna try and take out the sectoid, but if that doesn't work, I'm gonna have to hope that the flashbang does. Oh, 11 damage. That could have killed the mech in full health. So there's loot. Yeah, they're onto you, indeed. How far can you put that flashbang, actually? Because if you can, yeah. Okay. I do want to check out your shots chances as well. 48, that's actually not good enough. That's not good enough, so I'm going to put you closer just to add a bit of bait. And then toss the flashbang right on top of his face. So that should blind him and hopefully make him miss whatever he's going to try and do. Hopefully he's not going to kill Friar, because he could very well do that, but he's disoriented. Here goes nothing. Everything. Fingers crossed. He's pointing backwards. Is he going to go that way or what is he going to do? Because disorientation might do crazy things to troops. Okay, he's going to move back, yeah. Oh, he's going to fire at the civilian. Oh, you asshole. Good luck, he missed. You know what? He's probably the last enemy on the map, so... I think. I don't know why. Yeah, okay. So there we go. We have a variety of ways we can kill this guy now. Can we actually reach with the sword? We can't. What else do we have? I think I want to have... Benito have a shot at him, because I want to have a promotion on him. Not that he'll have one, I think. There's something on the ground there as well. One of the data pads flew all the way over here from... that's probably linked to the loot over there. So let's try. 58%. Here goes nothing. miss. That's not bad. We have plenty of troops left to take him out. And there we go. Maybe Christoph. No, I'm gonna try and get Cecil pop a shot here first.
Moving up.
There we go, full cover. 38% shot. That's not great, but it's a chance. And there he goes, straight through the rocks. Eviscerated.
Kill confirmed.
And that should save the rest of the civilians as well. I think. Yeah, there we go.
Confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed.
Yes. So one soldier got wounded by a, well, a surprise faceless that got a really nice swipe in. But, well, all things considered, pretty well, because a Muton, a Mac, a Sector, that's all very high level enemies. So, and we killed all of them with only one wounded, and we only lost 5 civilians as well, so continue. So, pretty nice stats again. Nobody got on the fire because the swipe is not fire. Christoph again moved the furthest as the runner. Cedric dealt most damage and Benito made most attacks, so that was really nice. And I hope I get a promotion for Cecil there, that he can get, what is it? I think it's blast padding or shredder, right? So let's check out the promotions. I think we have at least 2, might be more. I didn't check all of them because Cedric got the promotion.
Work out there, Commander.
Okay, so Ulrich got a promotion, Cedric got a promotion, and Harambe got a promotion. With 3 kills, actually. Wow, that was amazing. So let's check him out first. Ooh, there we go. Thanks to the efforts of the Advanced Warfare Center, this soldier has learned a combat ability outside of their area of specialization. Guardian, with every successful Overwatch shot, there is a 50% chance that another shot will be taken. So if we hit an Overwatch shot, we have a 50-50 chance that he fires again at the same target. So that might be very handy. Especially if we can give him an expanded magazine. With that in mind, I actually want to add Shredder to that. Because if he's going to be firing a lot, I want to give him Shredder. So there we go. Yeah, thank you very much. And now we have Ulrich. He is wounded, but we're going to start doing... Shredder and demolition. You deal no damage to your target with demolition, so that's not really handy. But suppression, yeah, I think I'm gonna just go for suppression. There we go. And Cedric, what else can you give me, good man? Death from above, killing an enemy at a lower elevation with your sniper rifle costs only a single action and does not end your turn. So that means with death from above, we can fire twice if he's at an elevated position. Which would actually be nice. Quick draw is also very nice. Firing your pistol with your first action no longer ends your turn. So that would mean that with lightning hands combined, we could fire 3 times with the pistol in a single turn. But I think we want to build him out as a sniper because of his immense aim. Because he's higher than TrophyNet, the character TrophyNet, Vinny. His aim is a lot higher, so we're going to go for death from above. There we go. And that's 3 promotions in the bag. He's sergeant. So Cedric is now a lieutenant, so we still don't have the next squad upgrade. But we have an upgrade for our first next squaddy as well. So Illyrium Corps. Oh, and there we go. Advanced expanded magazine. So that's going to go on Cecil Bavarius Harambe's minigun and another alien data cache. And of course the troopers, well, the corpses of everything we killed. Data encryption and the Muton autopsy. The aliens' primary shock troops are even more dangerous than they were when we faced them during the invasion. Our hope is that we can emulate their plasma-based explosives for our purposes. That would be very nice indeed.
Effort, Commander. My expectations were high, and yet you have exceeded them.
Thank you, Councilman. Thank you very much. There we go. So that was another successful retaliation mission. So we got a bit out of that. Let's go to the soldiers first and get that expanded magazine equipped on Harambe immediately. So Grenadier Harambe. Check him out. And then let's check the weapon upgrades. I gave him a hair trigger to start out with because I don't think hair triggers are really good. Especially the very low one. So 5% chance that a shot will not cost an action. As well, it's kind of bullshit. So let's go for the Advanced Expanded Magazine. Thank you very much. So he can fire 5 times without reloading. Let's see. Do we have... We still have the autoloader. I still want to put that on Cedric. So we're going to have to wait with that. Especially since he's going to have, with that from above, he's going to be firing more. So we're going to have to wait for the next upgrade to give him that. What else do we have? We're still clearing this out. And I might want to check up on the infirmary. And check up, because yeah, there we have Vryer in the med bay. And Benito seems to be visiting his dear friend in the infirmary. Looking nice. I'm going to have to check in the armory here. Check out the soldiers. How long is he out? For 3 days. That's good. So that's the advanced warfare center at work there. And now we got an extra ability as well, because that's going to be very handy every time that happens. Because the Advanced Warfare Center increases the chance that we get another ability every time a soldier levels up. So, let's head to the bridge. And I think we were still scanning at something. Ooh, a radio beacon. What were we scanning? Reduce contact cost. Huh. So, the supply drop is going to happen in 6 days as well. So with that in between, I'm gonna forfeit the reduced contact cost and go for the Avenger power, because power is always needed.
Avenger plotting new course.
There we go, let's head over there and see how much we can get from that. I'm wondering if we're gonna get another mission before the supply drop. I would actually want to have that, because more missions means more stuff, of course, as long as we don't die, well, don't have any soldier losses. So the black side is still a mission we can do, but I'm gonna wait with that a bit. So let's just scan at the radio beacon here. So that's 3 days. In 3 days we're gonna have the supply drop. So if nothing pops, Skulljack is gonna pop first. There we go. So access to the alien communications network is highly restricted, requiring several complex biomedical augments before admittance can be granted. The Skulljack allows us to hack into the network by temporarily wresting control of a being's augments, though any access gained is sure to be short-lived. And that is actually a sword that actually works on a specialist, which we can instantly kill one of the normal troopers. So as if the Skulljack itself wasn't invasive enough, Tygon has conceived of a more thorough means of extracting information from advent soldiers' chips. This new skill mining technique could lead to new intel gains from our enemies, and could even grant access to hidden alien facilities for the purpose of sabotage. I can also upgrade our skill checks to significantly enhance the hacking ability of any soldier carrying one. So another very interesting proving grounds project, which we'll check immediately, because I do want to have those running as much as I can. So proving grounds, so no items in building queue, so let's choose a project. So it's 5 days for the skull mining. We have a few Illyrium cores, and what I want to start off with is one of the experimental grenades. Just to see what we're gonna get. So experimental grenades, and then the skull mining, stack that on top of each other. I don't actually know how many Illyrium cores we have. Quickly gonna check that. I think we can check that in engineering, if I'm not mistaken.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
View inventory. Illyrium cores. We still have three, so I think I'm gonna add proving ground.
Having never stepped foot in one of the city centers, I've never actually had one of these advent burgers I keep hearing rumors about. No one really seems to be asking the hard questions either. Like, when was the last time you even saw a cow?
So yeah, because the aliens sell advent burgers, and there's a running joke as to what meat is inside of those burgers. But we're gonna add experimental ammo to that as well. We're gonna need
right away, Commander.
Yeah, okay, so we're gonna need those extra Illyrium cores as much as we can, because a project in the future I'm gonna have to invest in a lot of those as well. So let's go back to the bridge, and now we're probably gonna have our supply drop first before we complete the Avenger power. Oh no, we got that first. Passing low above the terrain, we spotted smoke rising from the remains of what was once a radio station and broadcast tower. Although the station itself is long since dormant, someone had rigged up a simple repeater using materials from the tower. Our engineering team was able to remove pieces of its generator and adapt them to boost the Avenger's power core, adding three power to our ship, meaning that we can build something without actually boosting one of the power generators that we have now. So, okay. I think if I just fly back to the Resistance, which I'm going to do, that's gonna cut us straight to the supply drop, I think. So if we do that, the travel will be enough. Probably halfway there, we're gonna have the supply drop. Or not. Well, let's just build faster a little bit then. There we go.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past.
Yes, yes, we did very well. So one retaliation stopped, one guerrilla ops completed, and two rumors investigated. We get 206 monthly supplies, which we get when we actually get the supply drop. We can get another sergeant or a doctor. Okay then, continue on. So we still have that one hidden event, and I'm kind of starting to be scared of what that might be. The alloy padding is bad as well, but let's reveal that. Alien cipher. The aliens increased the strength of their encryption, increasing all intel costs by 100% for a month. That's actually pretty bad as well. And the resistance informant. The aliens find a mole within the resistance, reducing their retaliation counter by 2 weeks. Okay, so that just means we get a retaliation mission faster. So in 5 weeks we're gonna have the next retaliation mission. Continue on then. And we have our supply drop, so let's investigate that immediately.
Avenger plotting new course.
So we get those extra supplies, and then we might check out what we can build with those extra supplies. If we don't get a mission in between. That's 1 day. 2 days. And okay, another room has been cleared. So let's check what we can build here immediately then. We have 15 power out of 18. So if we just think ahead and put one of the power generators there, that might actually put, you know what? There is, oh yeah, there's an exposed power coil over there. So if I can start building towards that, I think I might be fine for power. Yeah, so let's just build a workshop that should give us extra gremlins, which can replace engineers in the adjacent room. So let's go for workshop.
Workshop construction initiated.
There we go. Assign him here, indeed. So decrease. It's only 5 days to. No, 10 days because it's speed up. It's sped up. This is interesting. Do I want to have an engineer? So let's go out of build mode and let's remove the engineer over here. Because Freyr is already out of sickbay, so this engineer is doing nothing at the moment. So let's put her to work clearing that alien debris down there. There we go, and excavate. And then we can move towards that one after that excavation is done and put a power generator over there. We could still, when the workshop is done, we can put gremlins in the power relay, boosting the power output even more, so that's not bad at all. There we go. Back to the bridge. And we should get a mission anytime soon, because I think the experimental grenades are going to be first if it takes much longer. So ignore that. And ignore that as well. What else do we have? So the making contact is still available, actually. We should also start thinking about expanding our resistance comms, just so we can start contacting other continents such as Europe. Fire and ready, what does that do? All experimental ammo, grenade and weapon proving ground projects are completed instantly. That would be nice. I think I can actually also construct a radio tower, which would boost one of our areas over here. But I think New India actually has the most money gain. So I'm gonna have to wait with that. So let's just go to the amusement center for now.
Avenger,
and continue scanning over there. Because if we can get that bonus as well, unless it of course disappears while we're traveling over there. That would be very nice if we can get that as well. So that's the experimental grenades. There we go. Gas grenades. Ah, that's one of the worst one. So a fast-acting toxin allows the gas grenade to deal damage over a much larger area than our standard frag grenade, and any organic units caught in the blast radius will suffer the additional debilitating effects of poison over an extended period of time. That is not what we could have gotten, but something at least. Good against organic enemies mostly, so let's continue scanning. There we go. What is going to be first? Because plated armor is almost there as well. So the Avatar project increases again. Which is not bad, because I think it's going to be only one block. It's just progress. Yeah, there we go. On the Avatar project. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Down, we'll need to move fast. Yes, we will, but amusement center? At one time, Advent had planned on constructing a number of remote entertainment districts so that the city center inhabitants could take brief, monitored holidays abroad. This site was apparently the first and only of the experimental districts. A small settlement of refugees now exists nearby. Our scouts approached and offered them a chance at a better life in one of the havens established by the Resistance. Next region contact costs reduced by 50%. Okay. That is nice. And I think I'm going to go to the Resistance HQ and start setting building faster. Until we get something else. I could go to the black market as well, now that we're on the way, actually. Let's check that out really quickly. Because we might find, since another month has passed, we might find something useful to buy over there. Let's buy first, and let's see. We can buy alien alloys, iridium crystals, an advanced autoloader, another one. Advanced stock. Stocks add damage to missed shots, I think. Which would be nice as well. Advanced agility would be nice for... superior perception. Advanced agility would be really nice for Christoph, because he will be able to move even further. We could rush the research on gauss weapons. We have 157 intel left. The PCS chips are also really, really interesting, but we're going to go for the gauss weapons. There we go. That should do it. Let's see if we can sell anything. Very interested in trooper corpses. Let's give them a few. We only have two Viper corpses. And the rest, I don't think we really need to bother. So let's just sell those, giving us 30 supplies. So let's go out. And that means... You know what? I'm going to wait. Just continue scanning at Resistance HQ, because I think plated armor is, well, pretty much done. So let's build faster at the Resistance HQ. It's because it's taking a long time before we get another mission for some reason. Oh, guerrilla targets are first, so let's ignore that for now. Let's get back. Check out... Yeah, let's go to the lab. Research lab.
Hello, Commander.
Change research pretty...
But it will be some time yet before my research is complete.
Why isn't that completed? We could rush... Gauss weapons. Ah, I thought that would have been completed instantly then. Ooh, that was misleading. Okay, never mind. So that means we're gonna have to do without plated armor for one more mission. Sorry, Tegan. Sorry, Tegan. Didn't want to cut you off there. But let's check out the guerrilla operations. So West Asia, a scientist, and we counter the intel costs. That's not. It's also the furthest one away, so... No, it's not the furthest one away. That was the second one. That was the hidden one that we uncovered. So moderate. Difficult for an engineer. And moderate for supplies. The extra armor is gonna bite me in the ass otherwise, so... I might actually go for East Asia this time. So 150 supplies. Ooh, I could use a scientist though as well. Because this is hacking. This is destroying. But it's also the most difficult mission. Yeah, I'm gonna counter the alloy padding so that they, not every troop gets extra armor. So East Asia, let's see who we're gonna take. It's moderate, so I might actually take another of the rookies. And swap a few soldiers out again so that we have a different squad.
I'm going to be happy if we don't put the skulljack to good use. We should have one of our soldiers equip it before they deploy.
And that we will, because of course the perfect candidate to bear such a thing is Benito. So let's give him, instead of a frag grenade, the skulljack, which is going to be awesome. That for now it doesn't improve the hack stat, but it will if we are done with skull mining. Let's see, what else can we add to this? Advanced autoloader, still don't want to do that. So we want to do that on our sniper. could we go without a sniper for once? I think we should. I think we should go without the sniper and just put in Vrijer again and put two grenadiers in there. So let's edit Vrijer's loadout as well and give him the gas grenade that we just created. There we go. So now we have Vrijer and Harambe as our two grenadiers. Christophe will still be the ranger because we don't want to miss that. We still want to have a few good soldiers. I'm gonna miss Cedric on this mission. Really gonna miss him, but you know what? I'm gonna leave that decision up to the next episode. We'll see what we do next time. So before that, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching. And I hope to see you guys in the next video or series. Goodbye. Okay,